welcome the Holy Mass. Today is Friday in the third week of Easter. Our Mass is being offered for the intentions of Kevin and Jeannie O'Donnell. Our celebrant is Father Lepidi. Our entrant is Immaculate Mary, number 201 in the Brooklyn Bay, 201 in the Brooklyn Bay.
And you'll be told what you must do. And men were traveling with him, so to speak,
because I heard the voice of the casino bomb. Saw him up on the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand and brought him to Damascus. For 3 days he was unable to see, and he neither ate or drank. There was a disciple in Damascus named Ananias, and the Lord said to him in a vision, "Ananias." He answered, "Here I am, Lord." The Lord said to him, "Get up and go to the street called Straight, and ask at the house of Judas for a man from Tarsus named Saul. He is there praying, and in a vision he has seen a man named Ananias come in and let his hand off, but he may regain his sight." So Ananias replied, "Lord, I have heard from many sources about this man, but evil things have been done to him in Jerusalem, and we hear an order from the chief priests to imprison all who call upon our name." The Lord said to him, "Go, for this man is a chosen instrument of mine to carry my name for Gentiles, kings, and children of Israel, and I will show him what he will have to suffer for my name." So Ananias went and entered the house. Laying his hands on him, he said, "Saul, my brother, the Lord has sent me, Jesus, to appear to you on the way by which you came, and immediately things like that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit." Immediately things like scales fell from his eyes, and he regained his sight. He got up and was baptized, and when he had eaten, he recovered his strength. He stayed some days with the disciples in Damascus, and he began at once to proclaim Jesus in the synagogues that he is the Son of God, the Lord of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
This is the among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, unlike your ancestors who ate and still died. Whoever eats this bread will live forever." These things he said while teaching in the synagogue in Capernaum. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Second graders just recently received their first Holy Communion. And how beautiful this gospel is that we're all hearing from the very words of Jesus. Unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. That's a direct statement from Jesus, isn't it? And what does he mean? Because the people were confused back then. I know boys and girls were very smart. You understand what he means. Jesus is in that host, his real body and his real blood. He slips right into that host and he's present right in there. You may see the unleavened piece of bread, but truly, absolutely, it is the body and blood of Christ. See this statue in front of the altar? I keep on referring to this statue because that is of the risen Christ after he rose from the dead. He has real flesh and blood. Remember what he told the apostles? It's not a ghost, it is me. Take your hand and put it into my side. Take your finger and place it in the nail marks. It is truly me. A ghost does not have flesh and bones like I do. And yet how beautiful this miracle of the Eucharist is, that Jesus, to remain with us always and to live in us, he disguises himself in the piece of unleavened bread. And there he is. He's living within each of us. No wonder they were arguing among themselves, how can this man, who says he's God, give us his flesh to eat and his blood to drink? And you know what, boys and girls? Many of those people turned around and walked away. They did not believe in him any longer. The ones who remained understood beautifully what he meant. Did you also hear from the first reading from the Acts of the Apostles? And may I say, you read that so beautifully. The whole conversion of Saul of Tarsus, converting to Christianity. His name, Paul. But his name before he was a believer was Saul. And then when he believed, as Jesus spoke to him, he was baptized. And his name, Paul. You know, just to make a comment about that first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, you know, he was going to Damascus, and a bright light shone upon him. And you know what happens when a bright light shines upon us. We usually put up our hands to really dim the light because it's too bright. And it's very interesting that Jesus said that. Because Jesus is already now arisen to the right hand of the Father. And Paul is really killing all the Christians. And Jesus says to him, "Why are you persecuting me?" And Saul says, "Who are you? I'm Jesus whom you are persecuting." Because Jesus lives in every single one of those Christians through their baptism and through the Eucharist that they partake. Now they become one with Jesus. And so rightly he says, "You are persecuting me." Not you're persecuting John and Mary and Susan and Peggy and David. No, you're persecuting me because I am living within all of them. Well, he was later then converted and baptized, and he received how beautiful the grace of baptism, and he also received Holy Communion, Jesus living within him. And you know, he made such a big turnaround that he is one of the greatest missionaries and preachers of Jesus in the gospel. Mostly 99.9% of the time, you and I will hear the second reading at Sunday Mass from Paul's letters. He's done tremendous work. I'm wondering if sometimes you and I need to be knocked off our horse. We need to have a whole new vision so that we can see Jesus clearly and not just persecute him. And that Jesus will allow whatever is blinding us to allow us to see clearly, like Saul did and later Paul, so that we'll understand how beautiful it is when Jesus says, "Unlike your ancestors who ate manna in the desert, but they died, but whoever eats this bread that I give you will live forever."
Reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a greater love and the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for an increase in vocation to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially from members of our own parish family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them, Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offering hymn is Chasing Sea, number 332 in the Breaking Bread, number 332 in the Breaking Bread.
At your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, the good of all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land and every people exalting your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Oh.
once and once more giving it thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and Paul, the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and with all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Misericordiae,
Che Auguste, and Jacob, we told us to talk to you. Blessed are those who are called to suffer the land.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
662 in the breaking bread. Number 662 in the breaking bread.